The other day, I was pondering the abortion debate. One argument from the pro-life side goes something like this. If a pregnancy can be terminated after the second trimester, which is week 13 to week 28 of the pregnancy, what is the difference between a fetus at 28 weeks and a fetus at 27 weeks, 6 days, and 23 hours? What about 22 hours? 21? 20? You get the idea. But it's not that simple either. At the 28-week mark, different fetuses will have developed differently. How could one possibly impose a one-size-fits-all ruling on whether or not they're legally allowed to be aborted? It's just not reasonable. As I was thinking about this, I realized that there are similar incremental arguments about other things, like drunk driving laws. In the United States, if you're driving while your blood alcohol content is above 0.08%, it is a criminal offense. But why 0.08%? Why not 0.081%? Why not 0.082%? Or 8.3? Also, couldn't different people with that exact level of intoxication have different levels of impairment? Or perhaps in amusement parks. Do you ever see these "you must be this tall to ride" signs? Say a sign says 4 feet. Why not 3 feet 11 inches? 10 inches? 9? There's no denying it. These rules are arbitrary. But that's not necessarily a bad thing. We can't reasonably expect a tailor-made set of rules for every individual. That's just inefficient. If we go without some of these rules, kids might get thrown out of roller coasters at amusement parks, or die in drunk driving accidents. So the line has to be drawn somewhere. So how do we determine these lines? Well, we trust experts to do it. Ideally, they collect data to average out where the best lines can be drawn. We must trust them because we can't reasonably be expected to scrutinize every rule and scour the data with our own busy lives. Now, these lines will never be perfect, as I alluded to earlier, but we do the best we can. But who will draw these lines? There are two options: voluntary associations or government. An association can be anything: a business, a country club, your Dungeons and Dragons group. They're people who rely on people wanting to voluntarily associate with them. When they draw the boundaries, it's to maximize benefit and minimize risk to their own groups. How small can kids be to ride the Ferris wheel before it's unsafe? 2 feet and two young kids could get hurt. 6 feet and even most adults won't be able to ride it. It's a razor wire seesaw balancing act. Some of these associations have an incentive to get right. Contrast the government priesthood. Politicians' incentive is only to get through the next election. Do they lose money if the boundaries they draw suck? Nah, it's not their money. Votes? Well, here's a better question. How many Americans do you know the names of their congressional district's House member? You expect me to believe that they'll know that because of their congressperson, the abortion law says 28 months instead of 28 weeks? It doesn't, by the way, that's just an example. Outside of the, criticisms, I'm actually not trying to criticize these rules. These boundaries will be necessary in a free, voluntary society. It's just a thought I had about the legitimacy of fundamentally arbitrary rules. My conclusion? Context is all important, as a boundary doesn't always need to be there. But yes, arbitrary rules can be legitimate. And just because you might be able to drive with a blood alcohol content of 0.08%, that doesn't mean other people will be able to. Who would have thought? What do you think? Leave a comment below and inform me of what a complete and utter moron I am.